Welcome everybody so much. Thank you for being here. It is Andrew, and I'm sure you guys are excited as I am to talk about this guy, the Brydge 10.2 Max Plus. Just announced, literally just announced, and available now for pre-order with orders beginning to ship in late March. So if you want to get in on that pre-order train early, you can do so with the link below in the description. But this is really your first look at this device and doing a hands-on. So let's go ahead and take a look at this because it has a number of firsts for Brydge, including the first collaboration with OtterBox, the first like plastic keyboard, and the first set of new hinges that they've done in a long, long time that are magnetic. So there's some cool stuff to check out. So let's go ahead and dive into the Brydge 10.2 Max Plus. So the Brydge 10.2 Max Plus is designed for the 7th and 8th generation iPad. If you've got anything older, this is not going to support it. If you've got an iPad Pro, there's a dedicated keyboard model, trackpad model for those guys. So in this case, really just the 7th and 8th gen iPad, which is kind of a new whole market for Brydge now because they were really targeting that upper end of those pro users with like the Pro Plus keyboard trackpad. Now we have this one, which is super enticing because it's got that new lower price plus the case, plus everything else in there. It's a pretty compelling options for a lot of business users as well as students. So that education market is really going to be loving this guy. Fortunately, I've been using the new Brydge 10.2 Max Plus for a couple weeks now on my entry-level 8th gen iPad. So a few things to take a look at on the device itself. As I mentioned, it's a kind of, this is their first OtterBox collaboration. OtterBox made a strategic investment in Brydge in late 2020, and this is like the first kind of product to come out of that investment. So it's an OtterBox case co-branded with Brydge on there, and the entire unit, keyboard, case, everything is gonna give you 4 feet of drop protection. So it meets those mil-spec standards. So I really think it's important for drop protection, especially for a lot of people on the go, especially students. You want a device that's going to be rugged and durable and not gonna fail you. So drop protection built into this guy from the beginning. So we can open this up and we've got the case. Now the next thing to look at here is the hinges. So these are a new set of hinges for Brydge. Brydge has always been known for their hinges, and these are kind of an iteration on that design. These new ones are magnetic, so they're not completely, they're partially kind of holding it, partially magnetic, and it makes it really easy just to go ahead and remove it's weird because I don't have the tablet in here, because it's like just bending the case a little bit, but it easily comes out when you need it to, and then it really just aligns itself perfectly when it goes back in. So it's really easy to take it in and out and take off the case and the iPad when you need to and get rid of the keyboard. So it's really handy. Before, with the regular Brydge hinges, they can be a little bit finicky, a little bit difficult to take on and off sometimes. So I really like this new design. Case here, OtterBox, it's a very thin case, easily pops on, boom, got your iPad all ready to go. And then it just clips right there into the keyboard. You've got it, take it with you. When you're done, just pull off the iPad and you're set. It's very easy. It maybe looks awkward on camera, but here, and then it just pulls free. Really, really simple to take that on and off. So we have new hinges going on in the back. We have a new OtterBox case, got Apple Pencil slot there. All the ports are open, easy to access, very standard kind of OtterBox design. And then we have the keyboard itself. So it is a plastic keyboard, but it has rubberized edges. It actually feels kind of like an OtterBox case. So very solid, durable construction, full set of keys in the center. We have a dedicated row of function keys along the top, iOS specific, things like your brightness, the backlight to control the keyboard backlight, the media controls, volume, all of that is on there. And we have the mic button there in the lower left-hand corner. Then in the center there, this is probably the coolest part, we've got that trackpad built in. So a full integrated trackpad that you can use throughout iPadOS. Now about a year ago now, Apple introduced iPadOS, I think 13.4, which introduced trackpad support for the first time. And with the original Brydge keyboards, it was a little bit funky, but we've been using this new firmware. We already demoed it on the Pro Plus models for the iPad Pros, but that same firmware is coming here to the Brydge 10.2 Max Plus. And it is just a huge difference. This trackpad is phenomenal. It's nearly as good as Apple's, you know, Magic Keyboard. And the fact that you're getting kind of that Magic Keyboard experience here on an entry-level iPad is outstanding. And honestly, this may be just anecdotal or just kind of in my head, but I feel like this performance is better. I don't know if it's because it's a newer product, like newer hardware than the Brydge Pro Plus for the iPad Pros, but this trackpad feels very responsive, very solid. It just flies throughout the OS. I'm really happy with how smooth and nice this trackpad's performance is on this keyboard or this iPad. So it's pretty amazing. I love being able to, you can do just more with it. I mean, whether you're editing text, you're kind of traversing a document, you're trying to multitask or anything, it's just so much easier to be able to move around with a mouse, especially when you can multitask, you know, swiping your fingers side to side to jump between full screen apps, open up all your apps at once, anything like that. It's just so nice and easy to do with a trackpad built in here. So I think for, you know, a lot of productivity users, which again, who this tablet, this cover, case, everything is aimed at, it's just going to be an absolute slam dunk. So that's it. This is the Brydge 10.2 Max Plus first look review. We've been using it for a few weeks now, and I am just more than impressed with this guy for the new lower cost price point, and it's such a good package compared to what the other keyboard options are that are out there, let alone one that has a trackpad, and such a reliable trackpad as this one. You really can't beat it at that price point. So if you guys wanna grab one, again, up for pre-order now, starting $129 for this guy, 7th and 8th gen iPads, go ahead and pick one up, and when they start shipping in late March, let me know what you guys think. Find me on Twitter at Andrew_OSU, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.